also verifiable by anyone anywhere. For instance, if I send you pounds right now, or since block Bitcoin came into the system in 2009, every transaction that has been done, you can trace all of it on the blockchain.
It's recorded.
It's recorded
and transparent.
Yeah, and cryptocurrencies are inflation proof. Every cryptocurrency is capped. Bitcoin has got 21 tokens or 21 coins. Yes. No more will be created. If anyone tries to create any more, the blockchain will expose that person because everything is right there on the blockchain to be verified.
And then has cryptocurrency received adoption that is in Zimbabwe and Africa at large? What is our attitude towards
it? In fact, it's very interesting. In Southern Africa, for instance, thousands of merchants accept cryptocurrencies. And any merchant that is actually accepting PayFast can also accept Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrency. The Nigeria Central Bank, for instance, is on record that nobody can stop cryptocurrencies, and all that they want to do is to kind of formulate policies and regulations around it. In Zimbabwe, it is so interesting.
Yes.
People are now importing cars from Japan with cryptocurrencies.
Yes.
The only cryptocurrency exchange where you can buy and sell your cryptocurrency in Zimbabwe is at Batanaya Garden, the market. And if they tell you the volume they are doing in the market, you will be surprised. So Zimbabweans are getting to know cryptocurrencies, and there are a lot of activities around.
And then you now tell us about SmartCash. Let's talk about SmartCash. What is SmartCash for?
Okay, so SmartCash is another alternative coin that was launched in July.
Oh,
as we speak, yes, number 39 on the rankings on CoinMarketCap.
They're ranked by?
CoinMarketCap ranks all these cryptocurrencies. And at the moment, SmartCash is on number 39. SmartCash employs what we call community governance in cryptocurrencies. It actually deepens the decentralization in the system. So it gives everyone who belongs to the network a voice. You can be part of the decision making by voting on decisions that has to be made in the network. If you have to, say, open the network to make it the blocks bigger, you can place it on voting for everyone who wants a coin. If you even own one coin, you can vote. And then we have innovative things like cryptocurrencies basically get their value from demand and supply. The more people are buying, the more the value goes up. So what SmartCash is doing to make sure that price goes up is what. And then we have innovative things like cryptocurrencies basically get their value from demand and supply. The more people are buying, the more the value goes up. So what SmartCash is doing to make sure that price goes up is what they call the price stabilization mechanism, known as smart reward.
Yes.
And smart rewards allow people to earn some percentage of the coin they hold every month if they don't move any of those coins, just to make sure that the stabilization of the price is maintained. So Bitcoin actually created the opportunity for people to exchange value. But more other coins like SmartCash are bringing innovations into the system to make the ecosystem very beautiful.
They are doing the checks and the balances.
Exactly.
All right. And that is the president of the Africa Blockchain University, that is Africanus Kofi Okosa. And he's talking about cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin, and more recently, number 39 on the list, that is SmartCash. We continue with the Good Morning Zimbabwe. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me.
All right. Zimbabwe's financial services sector is set to benefit.
That allows you to send money to anyone, anywhere in the world, peer to peer, without going to the third party. And actually, Bitcoin is the first cryptocurrency that came on the market in 2009. And the success of Bitcoin has actually led to so many cryptocurrencies coming to the market. And if you go on CoinMarketCap, a platform that actually ranks cryptocurrencies according to their market cap, you will find about more than 1,400 cryptocurrencies in the system now being traded, and people are buying and selling it like that. And you can see their daily volumes, their market cap, and then their market price.
1,400
cryptocurrencies, yeah. So any cryptocurrency that came after Bitcoin is known as altcoin or altcoin, alternative coin.
alternative to Bitcoin.
Yeah.
And what are some of the problems associated with cryptocurrencies?
Cryptocurrencies ensure that there are lower transaction costs. Unlike the banks where you have to pay so much to transact. You can pay a few cents for transacting any amount of money or transferring any amount of money anywhere. And if you look at the unbanked population in Africa, cryptocurrency is the solution to that. So many people don't have access to the bank accounts because of bureaucratic tendencies and the process you have to go through before you can have access to bank accounts. You can easily have an account, a crypto account on your cell phone, on your PC or your tablet. And if you look at how smartphones are becoming so popular and everybody getting to use it in Africa, these are some of the things it can really bring to Africa and also kind of help people exchange goods and services and to also exchange value, especially in cross-border trading.
But this notion that it's a scam, it's a Ponzi scheme.
I always laugh at that because you look at guys like Davis,
yes.
Richard Branson of the Virgin Group,
yes.
John McAfee, the antivirus guru,
yes.
The computer antivirus guru.
Yes.
All these people have endorsed cryptocurrencies. And the truth is, cryptocurrencies are actually bringing more transparency into the world because the application that powers every cryptocurrency, which is known as the blockchain, is basically a public distributed ledger, which is said that anything you place on it is immutable, and then it is also verifiable by anyone anywhere. For instance, if I send you pounds right now, or since Bitcoin came into the system in 2009, every transaction that has been done